I can remember very well. It was in 1991. My daughters and I were living in Jaffna after my husband died. We were there. And again the war broke out suddenly, and the railway, the trains weren't running, and I was stuck in Jaffna. My children came to Colombo for an exam and they were here. And I couldn't leave because I was working, and I couldn't leave my staff and the work. Then some or other, 3 months later, a replacement was sent to take over my work, and through a different difficult route through Mannar, I came back to Colombo. And it was quite a nerve-wracking experience getting out of the north at that time. And a couple of days later, I get a call from Sithie. Sithie, who I hadn't seen for many years. So she calls and says, Neelan told me you have come and reached Colombo. Can I come and see you? So I said, of course, come. And she came and saw me in this house, that's the same house which was burnt in 83, and in 91 it was like a ghost house, so run down and nobody had occupied, and the garden was all squashed because of the no one was there to look after this place. And when Sithie came, she walked around our two rooms where we were, my children and I were living. And she didn't say much. She said, I want to talk to you about your experience, how you managed to get out and all that. And we fixed a time and she went. Then 2 days later, a pickup truck comes and stops in front of our house, the so-called house. And she has sent all the things she didn't want, and she collected from where, I don't know. Furniture for the little place I was living, clothes cabinet, even potted plants to cheer us up because the garden was really bare. So we had all these flowering pots of plants, and then kitchen few utensils. You know, she's so thoughtful, and nobody even... There were one or two people who came and visited us, my family, my mother was here, but no one reached out to us as Sithie did. I'm sure she has done this for many people. Her kindness was unbelievable.
My name is Manaina, and I have been a community activist and a human rights activist in Northern Ireland for about 45 years now, and I work with the Community Foundation for Northern Ireland. I first met Sithie in Belfast in 2003 and have known her therefore for a relatively short time in the scheme of things, but those have been amazing years in terms of the development of a respect and friendship that has meant a great deal to me personally, as well as to our Community Foundation and to the members of the International Foundations for Peace Network, the idea behind which attracted Sithie to our Belfast meeting in the first place. We are devastated at her loss to the wider social justice and peace-building sisterhood. Sithie was able to transform the personal tragedy in her life into the strength required to become a well-known and internationally respected human rights defender. She was totally clear in her belief in the sanctity of life, clear about justice, human rights, and equality for every human being. Her family, friends, and colleagues have lost a loyal, feisty, and loving woman. She was very committed to the Foundations for Peace network from its outset. So we at Foundations for Peace have lost a founder member, our first chairperson, affectionately referred to as our queen. We mourn her very deeply. My memories are full of examples of her courage and hope in the face of huge personal tragedy. Her refusal to be bowed or to give up the struggle for peace with justice in her beloved country, even when there seemed no space for hope. Her anger at the ongoing human rights abuses and the abuse of power were legendary. And yet sitting alongside this was her passion for life, her enormous sense of fun and devilment. She often remarked on how she shared the dark sense of humour of our Irish sisters, while enjoying irreverent conversations with us, plotting to put the world to rights. And we had another thing in common, our beloved but troubled homelands, our islands. So from one emerald isle to another city, we salute ye, and are confident that your legacy will live on in NTT, FFP and elsewhere. Rest in peace, sister, with your beloved Neelan. Slán a bhaile, safe home.